Thank you. My name is Claudia Reinhardt. I'm from Germany. I'm living in Berlin. And I'm teaching in Norway as well. So I live in Norway part-time as well. I work there as an associate professor at the Academy in Bergen. This photo, which you can see here and which is shown in the exhibition as well, is called Sylvia. And it's one photograph out of 10 stage photographed from the series called Killing Me Softly, Todesarten. I recreated the suicide of female artists by imagining their very last moment and pictured myself in the roles of these personalities. And this one, Sylvia, refers to Sylvia Plath, which I think is well known in the US. I all started with Sarah Kane, which is this one, it's called Sarah. And Sarah Kane committed suicide in 1999. I was very shocked when I was reading about her suicide, and I was very sad as well, because I just discovered her writings, and I was very into her work. So I couldn't get this sadness out of my head. And I noticed that, that there are quite many writers and artists who committed suicide. So this was the trigger, so to say, that I started to deal with this female artists, and I was going into biographies and in the work of artists who committed suicide. And what I was interested in and what I was thinking of was if there is any connection to these artists. Why, in a way, I was thinking, why did they commit suicide? But of course it was not possible, and in the end I don't think that I was really looking for this answer, but I was looking for, is there something they have in common? And I think I can, they have something in common. It's difficult to explain in few sentences, and I don't want to do that, but that was the reason why I did the whole series. And if you watch the images and the book I made, I think you can follow and you can find this connection these artists have. But I should go on with my notes, and otherwise I talk too much. I just go on and tell some facts and details about these artists. This is Anne Sexton. Anne Sexton committed suicide in 1974, and she was an American poet, and she discovered writing as a way to save her own life. That was what she was saying about herself or her work. And later on, when she was already famous, she took her mother's fur coat, went into the garage, sat down in her car, and left the engine running. And this story about that she was wearing the fur of her mother, I was reading in a book. And I don't know if this is true, but I found, of course, many stories about how they commit suicide, and like this legends, there is always material you can find about their deaths, and it's, and I don't know if it's true, but sometimes I used it and sometimes not. In this case, I thought this is a nice picture in a way. This is Diane Arbus. She lived from 1923 to 1971. She was an American photographer, and she slit her wrist in the bathroom of her studio. There is a persistent legend that she photographed her own death, which I also can't prove, but I thought this is interesting idea as well, and this is the only photo I photographed with the time, how do you say, self-timer. In the other photos, I have an assistant who is putting the trigger, but of course the scenery I'm staging and putting everything, arranging everything. This is Ingeborg Bachmann. She lived from 1926 to 73, Austrian writer, and she burned to death in her bed after falling asleep with a cigarette. It's not known to this day whether it was an act of suicide or a tragic accident. This is Unika Zürn. She lived from 1916 to 1970, German writer and anagram poet, threw herself out of the window of her companion Hans Bellmer's apartment after being released from a mental hospital. This is Adelheid Duvanel. She lived from 1936 to 1994. She was a Swiss writer, and she put she took poison and was going in a forest and was actually freezing to death in a summer night. This is really strange, but it's true. This is Clara Imava. Clara Imava is the only character who is not an artist I have in the series, but I picked her because when I was researching and for this matter, my sister actually, she told me, "Do you know Clara Imava?" And I didn't. Read her biography, and that was very interesting because she belongs in this series. She was a scientist living she was born in 87 and she died in 1915, so she was one of the first women in Germany who did her doctor in chemistry. And her husband Fritz Haber as well. He's very well known as a scientist, and because he invented the poison gas, which was used in the First World War, and Clara Imava was totally against his investigation and in his involvement in this war, and she killed herself with his gun in their garden in Berlin as a protest, I suppose, or I'm sure. But the family destroyed all her letters where she was complaining and describing her anger against this action of her husband. But they destroyed and burned all her letters. This is Karin Boje. She lived from 1900 to 41, and she was a Swedish writer. She wrote poems and two novels. She fell in love with a female German writer with whom she experienced the rise of the Nazis in Germany and killed herself with poison on a wooded hilltop with a valley view. This is, I didn't know this writer before I started with the series, and my students told me about her, and then I was researching as well. There are not so many, her poems are all not translated. And there are only two novels translated in Germany, but very badly, I think. But I could get it that she is a great, or was a great writer, and very interesting biography. And this image, I created this image because when I was looking for material of her, I discovered a web page made by her brother, who's now 80 or 90 years old, and it was really nice. It was in the beginning when you open when you come on the web page, it said that she was going to her favorite spot where she lived, and that she sat down on a tree, took poison, and a child was coming along to bring her flowers because this child was looking for her, and this child knew where her favorite spot was and was going to her. It's also a legend, but I thought this is a really beautiful picture again. And the last one is the only male artist I have in the series. It's called Pierre and refers to Pierre Molinier. I have him in the series because I'm a fan of Pierre Molinier. Like, I'm a fan of all these artists I have in the series. It's a homage, in a way. And and Pierre Molinier was dressing up as a woman usually, and was doing self-portraits, very beautiful black and white collages with him and with mask and wigs, and very fantastic. And he committed suicide because he was old, or he was thinking he's old. I mean, he was 70, and he had prostata cancer. Yeah, and so he left a goodbye letter saying, "I'm bored to death. I don't want to live anymore." So, yeah, that's the whole series. And I did a book with all these images and texts about all these artists, and these texts are written by 10 female authors, which I have a close relationship with. They are friends, or we became friends during this work. And so if there are like more information about these artists. Yeah, I think that's all. Thank you.